Okay, so the first thing I'm going to be doing is reviewing the order for the central line dressing change and for the secondary IV medication administration. I'm going to gather all my supplies and go into the patient's room and perform hand hygiene. Hi, my name is Adriana. I'm going to be the nurse taking care of you today. Today we are going to be doing a central line dressing change and starting your secondary IV medication. Can you please tell me your name and date of birth? Okay, and I would also ask the patient if he has any allergies. I would make sure that the bed is in a comfortable working height and make sure that the head of the bed is lower than 30 degrees. For this demonstration, it's gonna be higher than that. I would ask the patient to turn his head away from the central line insertion site. And if not, I will apply a mask. So now I'm gonna open the kit and remove the mask and be careful not to contaminate the rest of the kit. I'm going to apply the mask here on top. And I'm just gonna go ahead and take out the other mask from the kit as well, and then apply clean gloves. Okay, so with the clean gloves, I'm gonna remove the old dressing by working distally and moving proximately and making sure that I stabilize the catheter with my thumb. So it's much harder to remove on a teddy bear. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of that, dispose of that, and then I am just gonna put a small piece of tape just to hold it in place while I do this. I am gonna inspect and palpate for any signs of infection, redness, swelling. And just assess around the surrounding area as well. And then I'm going to remove my gloves and perform hand hygiene. So now I'm going to put on my sterile gloves. Try to get this into the picture. Ahead and fix this glove as well. Okay. So now I'm going to clean the site with the ChloraPrep, and I'm going to start at the insertion site and work my way outward in a circular motion. So let me get that opened. I'm just going to bring this back over so you can see it. So I'd break this and then in a circular motion work my way outward, And I'm also gonna clean the insertion tube. Okay. Get rid of that. I'm gonna allow the area to air dry, and then I'm also going to use the skin prep. And apply that on the skin, working my way outward. And now I'm gonna apply the transparent dressing over the central line and make sure that I covered like the insertion site. So I'm just gonna peel this off and apply that back on there. And then I'm going to, I'm going to remove my gloves and my mask, perform hand hygiene, and then I'm going to write the time, date, and my initials. And put that onto the dressing out of the way of the actual dressing site. So I'll kind of put that down low. Okay, and after performing two med checks outside of the patient's room, I'm gonna perform the third med check by comparing the IV medication with the MAR. So using aseptic technique, I'm going to remove the secondary IV tubing from the package. There we go. And then I'm also going to open my secondary tubing here. Okay, so let me undo this here. Okay, so keeping it sterile here using the aseptic technique, going to take this off and spike, while not touching either of these, I'm going to go ahead and spike this, spike the bag. Decompress the tubing here. Make sure that it's clamped, and then slowly prime the tubing to make sure that there is no air bubbles. And I would also label the IV tubing per agency policy. and now I'm going to hang the IV bag on the IV pole higher than the primary tubing. So just hang this on the IV pole. And then with an alcohol swab, I'm going to connect this to the B port on the primary tubing. So I would clean this off with an alcohol swab. And then pop this blue cap off and connect the two. Okay. And then I'm going to program the required info into the secondary pump, IV pump, just to make sure that my pump settings and flow rate calculation is all correct and being infused. I'm going to dispose of all my supplies here and make sure that the patient is in a comfortable sitting position with both side rails up and the collet in reach and the bed in the lowest position.